this Delft-y pot is marked for Jacob Wemmers van Hoppenstein, who was the full owner of the Moriaanshoofd, the Morshead factory, from 1664 until 1671. However, the teapot was probably made around 1675 during the period that the Moriaanshoofd factory was owned by Jannetje, the widow of Jacob Wemmerszoon. An ordinance from 1652 allowed widows of potters to continue the business of their deceased spouse without having passed the obligatory guilds test. The objects made by the Moriaanshoofd factory in this period are amongst the rarest and most remarkable of all Delftware production. Just like this teapot, they are characterized by particularly milky white glaze and soft blue painting with distinct ornamentation of scrollwork borders. The present teapot draws strong inspiration from Chinese porcelain teapots. The overhead handle is a shape that is often seen at Guangxi porcelain, while the teapot itself mimics the form of Chinese Hixing red stoneware teapots. Also, the decoration appears to be an emulation of Chinese transitional porcelain. To create this hexagonal-shaped teapot, the Delft potters must have used plaster molds, since it is impossible to throw a piece with so many angles. Only a few teapots are known that are similar to the present teapot. Firstly, a similarly shaped, slightly smaller, and by the way, unmarked blue and white teapot is in the collection of the Boijmans van Beuningen Museum in Rotterdam. Further, there are four similar teapots, however, they are all marked for Rochus Hoppenstein, the son of Jacob. The first is in the Rijksmuseum in Amsterdam, and a smaller pair is in the collection of the National Trust in the Trevelyan Collection at Wallington, Northumberland. Another polychrome teapot marked for Rochus Hoppenstein, quite similar in shape but missing the high yoke handle, is in the collection of the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York City. The present teapot is the only example with the IW mark for Jacob Wemmers van Hoppenstein. We try to be forward thinkers. Click here to learn more about our belief in an ever greater mix of the physical and digital world. Also, find out about our ideas for the future and how we are preparing for it, even reaching the art world. If you enjoyed that video, we would appreciate a like. Click here to see more like it or subscribe to our channel by clicking the circle here. Thank you.